Okay, new chapter, which is chapter 4 on reproductive system. These are the learning objectives of chapter 4, which is the first one, compare and describe asexual and sexual reproductive processes. Second, compare and describe external and internal fertilization. The third learning objective is describe reproductive reproduction in vertebrates. This one we are going to look at the female and male reproductive system. And then next is describe the human gametogenesis process. For this one, we are going to look at the process of forming sperm cells and also oocytes, okay? Secondary oocytes in female, the male and female gametes, basically. And then the next one is describe pregnancy and human development. Okay, so for the first subtopic 4.1.1, types of reproduction in plants. So plant will undergo two different types of reproduction, which is sexual reproduction and also asexual reproduction. For sexual reproduction, it involves new plants arise through reproductive parts. Okay. So, for sexual reproduction, basically it involves the fusion of gametes, male and female gametes, resulting in offspring that that are genetically different from the parents. So, the offspring produced are genetically different because the production of gametes involve the process of meiosis. So, as you know, the process of meiosis will produce gametes that have different genetic composition. Okay, due to, for example, the crossing over and also the alignment of non-homologous chromosome at the metaphase plate. Okay, so and also the random fertilization of eggs by sperm. Okay, so this produce offspring that are genetically different from the parents, so they may have different phenotype from the parents. So the next one is asexual reproduction. So this one involves new plants arise from vegetative parts of an existing plant. Okay, so for example of vegetative part, you can have tubers. Okay, for example a potato. And then the new organism will be genetically identical to the parent, so they are cloned. Okay, so because the genetic composition are the same, they arise from vegetative parts of the parent. So the vegetative part will become new plants that have the same trait, okay, as the parent. Okay, so the first one is for asexual reproduction in plant. So basically, vegetative propagation is a type of asexual reproduction in plants involving the production of new plants from vegetative structures. So basically, for asexual reproduction, the offspring are produced from a single parent, from one parent. So example of vegetative part, you can have rhizome. For example, you can have turmerics, okay, turmeric, and then bulb such as onion, corm, plantlets, stolon, and tubers, okay. And another one is suckers. So basically, offspring are derived from a single parent without any fusion of egg and sperm. So we are going to look at one by one of the vegetative part. So for the first one is modified stem. So stem tubers are swollen underground stem tip, specialized for storing food, buds produce new shoots. So you have this potato, and the potato, if you leave it in a long time, okay, so they will produce buds. Okay, so this bud will produce new individuals that have the same genetic composition as the parent. Okay, so they are genetically the same. So example are potatoes, they have the same trait. And then another one is rhizome. Okay, modified stem is rhizome. So a rhizome is a horizontal underground stem. So new aerial shoots, like this one, okay, new aerial shoots arise from buds that develop develop on the rhizome. Okay, so you can have like, for example, turmeric or ginger. Okay, so those are example of plants that have rhizome. The next one is modified leaf or plantlets. So example here is Bryophyllum species and Kalanco species. Okay, so some plants produce plantlets along the edges of the leaf. So this is the leaf of the plant. Okay, so they will produce plantlets, and each of these plantlet, when they reach a certain size, they will fall off and grow into new plants. Okay, Bryophyllum is in the family of Crassulaceae, right? So the next one is suckers. So these are suckers, right? So the roots of some plant produce suckers which give rise to new plants. So for example, banana tree, roses, and also apple trees. So suckers or root sprouts, okay, are plant shoots that arises from bud on underground shoot a root or stem, okay. So asexual reproduction in plant. In some flowering plants, embryos in the seeds will produced asexually from the parent plant without fertilization. So there are plants where the seeds can be grown without fertilization. Okay, so this kind of asexual reproduction is known as apomixis. So seed produced in this way give rise to individuals that are genetically identical to the parents. So the offspring are maternal clones. Okay, because the offspring are derived. Okay, they arise from seeds. So obviously seeds comes from the female plant. So they have the same genetic materials as the female parent plant. Okay, the female plant. So example, citrus and also blackberries. Okay, so next is sexual reproduction in plants. Sexual reproduction in plants includes meiosis and the fusion of egg and sperms. Okay, so the fusion of egg and sperm is the process of fertilization to produce the embryo. So fertilization occurs within the flower's ovary. So after fertilization, flowering plants produce seeds inside fruit. Okay. So this is in this diagram you have a flower. Okay, so it shows you the female and male reproductive part of the flower. So in this flower it has two. Okay, male. It has both of the male and female reproductive part. So this one is the pistil. Pistil or the carpel is the female reproductive part, which includes the stigma, the style, okay, and the ovary. So within the ovary, there is a ovule, okay. Within the ovule, you have the eggs of the female gametes. And then for the stamen includes the anther and the filament, okay. So the anther is where the spore that contains the sperm will produced, okay. So this ovary will become when the eggs within the ovule is fertilized, okay. So the ovary will become the fruit and the ovule will turns into seed. So in this diagram it shows you the life cycle of a plant. So here you have a plant that is in the diploid stage. We call it as the sporophyte, diploid to N. And in the production of the male and female gametes, the male part here, okay, the male reproductive organ within the male reproductive organ, there's cell that will undergo meiosis, and same also in the female reproductive organ, okay, in the ovule. So it will undergo the process of meiosis. So the meiosis in the female reproductive organ or tract will produce megaspores, which is haploid. And then for male, it produces microspore, which is haploid. And then from that, microspore will become the pollen grain, and we call it as the megametophyte. And within it, you have three nucleus, which is two sperm nuclei here and also tube nucleus here. And then as for the female gametes, it produces this structure, which is the female gametophyte, the embryo sac, which is in the haploid stage, and also inside it you have the egg cells, okay, egg cell, which is in the haploid stage. So during fertilization, so from pollen grain from the anther will land on the stigma, okay. So the pollen will have this tube nuclei, and then it produces from the tube nuclei the pollen tube, where it allows the sperm nuclei, these two sperm nuclei, to penetrate into the female gametophyte here, okay, which has the egg cell within it, okay. So when the sperm nuclei has entered into this structure, so one of the nuclei will fertilize the egg, and the other one, the other sperm cell will fertilize the embryo sac, okay. So it is called as double fertilization, okay. So the fusion of sperm with the egg cell will produce the zygote, which is in the haploid stage, okay. So from that it undergoes mitosis, differentiation, and growth to become the whole plant again. So it starts here. Pollen grain from another plant lands on the stigma, okay. So this is the stigma, so this is the pollen grain that has the sperm nuclei, and then pollen tube grows. So this is the pollen tube that grows inside the style, okay. So pollen tube grows from pollen grain down the style and into the macrophylle and into the ovule. So this pollen tube will grow until it reaches the macrophylle here. So it penetrates the macrophylle here in the ovule. Okay. So two sperm nuclei are discharged into the embryo sac, resulting in the double fertilization. So as you can see here, you have two sperm nuclei. So one will fertilize the egg and the other one will fertilize the polar nuclei here. Okay. So the fertilized egg, which is the zygote, will develop into embryo. Okay. And then the ovule here will become the seed, and then the ovary here, the outside structure here, will become the fruit. So basically, for double fertilization that occurs, it involves one sperm, okay, one sperm to fuse with the egg, forming the zygote, and the second sperm, the other one here, okay, that fuses with the two haploid polar nuclei, forming the endosperm. So basically, endosperm is the tissue that surrounds and nourishes the embryo in the seed of angiosperm. Okay, so nourish the embryo as it germinates. Okay, so now we are going to look at types of reproduction in animals. So basically, in this diagram, how it illustrates how asexual reproduction occurs for animals that undergo asexual reproduction. So basically, asexual reproduction, it comes from a single parent. Okay. So a single parent, so this is a single, maybe a unicellular organism, okay, that undergo mitosis or cell division, okay, or binary fission. So it divides to divide the nucleus once the nucleus has divided, so the cytoplasm then divides to become the two new daughter cells. Okay, so basically this one it explains to you on asexual reproduction. Animals can undergo asexual reproduction and also sexual reproduction. So this one is the statements that explain asexual reproduction in animals. So it only involves one parent. It does not involve any fertilization. It does not involve the fertilization of egg by the sperm, and it involves only mitotic division, okay, division of cell. And then offspring have heredity trait identical to the parent, okay? So except if mutation occurs. So mutation will change the nucleotide sequence and produces new phenotype in that organism. But if there's no mutation, then the trait of the offspring will be the same as the parents, okay? So asexual reproduction is the fastest and the most efficient way of reproducing. Asexual reproduction in animals is divided into four types. You have the binary fission, fragmentation, parthenogenesis, and also budding. Okay, so preferably you just the spelling should be continuous here. Fragmentation, parthenogenesis. Okay. So the first one is binary fission. This one, it involves parent cell. Okay, in this cell you can see is a paramecium. Okay, so paramecium will undergo binary fission. So it involves the parental cell to divide into two cells of the same size. So as you can see, the parent cell start to divide into two cell. Okay, so each part will become a separate but identical organism. So example for organism that undergoes binary fissions are bacteria. Bacteria are prokaryote, unicellular organism, and amoeba, paramecium are unicellular eukaryotes. Okay, they are unicellular eukaryotes. They are protists. Okay, and then and also some algae will undergo binary fission. So next is budding. Okay, next is budding. So this one is budding. So parent. So this is the parent. This one is hydra. Okay, hydra will undergo budding. So parent produces bud. So this is the bud produced, and the bud gets detached and developed into offspring which is identical to the parent. Okay, so this is the bud that is that's going to grow and become the same as the parent. So the offspring is either will remain joined or it will detached, okay, from the parent. Okay, so it can remain attached to the parent or it can detached. So example are cnidarians and also sponges. Okay, cnidarian, you don't pronounce it as cnidarians, okay, or cnidarians, you pronounce it as cnidarians. Okay, so sponges, hydra, examples of sponges are hydra and also coral. Next is fragmentation. Okay, so as you can see, this one is you have the flatworms. Okay, flatworms. So fragmentation occurs when the body of the parent breaks into several pieces. Each piece regenerate the missing part and develop into a whole animal. For example, flatworm, nematodes, and also annelids. Okay. So this one you have a flatworm. So if you were to come across a flatworm, for example, the animal that can undergo this type of asexual reproduction, for example, you are really disgusted by this organism, you cut it into many pieces. Okay, you don't, by cutting this organism, you will not kill the organism, but you will generate more of the flatworms. Okay, so for example, you cut this flatworm into three pieces, the head, the mid piece, and also the tail. So each one will regenerate a new flatworms. So you have more flatworms. Instead of killing the flatworm, you have more flatworms. Okay, so that is fragmentation. So basically for this one, you have to take note that fragmentation is followed by regeneration. Okay, so every missing part will be regenerated. Okay, fragmentation and regeneration. So just jot that down. All right, fragmentation and regeneration. So the last one, the fourth one is parthenogenesis. So in this parthenogenesis, it involves a female, okay, that produce offspring from an unfertilized egg. Okay, so the female produce egg, but this egg can develop into a haploid individual, a haploid adult. Okay, because why is it haploid? Because the egg is not fertilized. Okay, so it is common among insects, especially honeybees and also wasps and other arthropods. All right, so in most species, parthenogenesis alternate with a period of sexual reproduction. So maksudnya kat sini organism tu bergantung kepada situation. So ada masa yang dia akan undergo parthenogenesis, ada masa dia akan undergo sexual reproduction. Okay, it depends on the situation. Okay, so for example of organism that can undergo both sexual reproduction and also parthenogenesis are the bees. Okay, so as you know, bees, they will have their queen. Okay, so it says here, without sperm, the eggs develop parthenogenetically into haploid male drones. Okay, so basically, you have to know that a queen, the bee queen, okay, will only mate once, okay, and store the sperm. Okay, store the sperm. She is in control of the release of the sperm. So if the queen decides she wants to produce more drone, okay, drone ni macam askar lah untuk koloni bee tu. Okay, askar dia, askar yang kawal koloni bee tu. So bila dia nak hasilkan drone, so dia akan develop the it will allows the egg to be developed to form male offspring without fertilization. Okay, without fertilization. So unfertilized eggs, which is haploid, will develop into male offspring. And if the colonies needs more worker, okay, or needs need to produce another queen, so the egg will be fertilized, okay, by the sperm stored earlier. Okay, the egg will be fertilized to form diploid individuals, okay, which is will become the female offspring. Okay, so the female offspring can be the worker or can become another queen. Okay, so ingat tu, male from unfertilized egg, okay, through parthenogenesis, but this one is through sexual reproduction. So where the egg is fertilized by sperm to form female offspring, which is it can become worker or another queen. Okay. So another type of parthenogenesis is this lizard. Okay. So it is a population of lizard. Okay, there is no male. Tak ada lelaki, tak ada jantan. Okay, so no males. So it is reproduced without fertilization through a parthenogenesis of virgin birth. Okay, so as you can see from this diagram here, you see a mating ritual. So usually you have a male and a female. Okay, in the normal mating ritual, but for this lizard, both are actually females. Okay, both are actually females. Courtship ritual. Okay, courtship ritual. So a courtship ritual is still required even though there is only one gender. Dua-dua ni betina. Okay, so one female takes the part of a male and the other takes the part or the role of a female. Okay, so dia akan take turn. Seorang akan jadi jantan, seorang akan jadi betina, tapi kedua-duanya sebenarnya dia adalah betina. Alright? So later, the two lizards switch role. So this is to promote. Kenapa perlu ada this courtship ritual ni? Kan? Padahal dua-dua female. Sebab through this courtship ritual, it will trigger the two lizards to release or increase the production of hormones. Okay, which is estrogen, which promote female behavior, and progesterone, which stimulate male behavior. Okay, so the courtship ritual is due to the role of these two hormones. Estrogen promotes female behavior, progesterone promotes male behavior. Okay, so with the significance of this mating, okay, or courtship ritual, is so that when you have a surge of the hormone, okay, surge of the hormone, it triggers ovulation to occur. Okay, it triggers ovulation to occur. So when ovulation occurs, eggs will be released. Okay, the eggs will be released and the eggs will develop into into a haploid organism, a haploid offspring. Okay, so the so basically the significance of this mating ritual is so that it induces the two lizard to become male at one point and female at one point. Okay, so this will trigger each of the lizard to ovulate and release egg. Okay. Okay, so next is sexual reproduction in animals. So basically, for sexual reproduction, it involves fusion of sperm and egg through fertilization. Okay, bila setiap kali awak nak fahamkan sexual reproduction, it must involve, okay, fusion of sperm and eggs, okay, through fertilization. So the eggs is large and non-motile with nutrients, and the sperm is small and motile. Okay, so sexual reproduction can occur between two organisms, male and female, but it can also occur in organism, okay, in one organism that has both male and female reproductive organs. Okay, so those, for those animal, we call it as hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite are animals that has both male and female reproductive organ and capable of self-fertilization. Okay, they are capable of self-fertilization. It does not require two separate individual. One individual that has both male and female reproductive organ and capable of self-fertilization. Okay, so this is the hermaphrodite, hermaphroditism. So hermaphroditic species can be either simultaneously hermaphroditic or sequential hermaphroditic. Okay, hermaphroditic species can be either simultaneously hermaphroditic or sequentially hermaphroditic. So in simultaneous hermaphroditic species, each individual is both male and female at the same time, although the ripening of the gonads may be sequential to prevent unnecessary self-fertilization. Okay, so ada masalah, ada masa-masanya yang mana male reproductive organ will mature, okay, and the other one and the female will mature at a different time. So this is to prevent unnecessary self-fertilization. So most free-living flatworms are hermaphrodites that reproduce sexually. Okay, that produces sexually. So they undergo self-fertilization basically. They can undergo self-fertilization and also the normal mating. Okay. So advantages, so by for this organism, so the advantage of having both male and female reproductive organs, okay, for hermaphrodite, they have both male and female. So this is the female part, okay, in one organism. So this is the female part. So they have testes, they have the ovary, testes to produce the sperm, ovary is to produce the eggs, okay. So advantage for sessile or burrowing animals and parasites that face difficulty in meeting members of the opposite sex. Maksudnya, bila dia advantage untuk organism yang seseorang dia je, kan? Parasite dalam perut animal, kan? Dia seseorang je. So, you all jadi peliklah, kenapa dalam perut tu ada seekor tapi boleh membiak dengan banyak, kan? Okay, disebabkan oleh dia boleh buat self-fertilization, okay? So, flatworms are capable of self-fertilization, so it requires less energy to seek out a breeding partner. So, example, flatworms, earthworms and also garden snails. Okay, so without partners, they can produce their own offspring because they have both male and female reproductive organ. Okay, kalau human, tak boleh. Okay, so hermaphroditism. So reef fish produce through sequential hermaphroditism. Okay, hermaphroditism. So in sequential hermaphroditism, individual is born one sex and changes sex at some point. Okay, sequential. So ada masa Contohnya ikan ikan ni refresh ni dia akan jadi jantan, ada masa dia akan jadi betina. Okay, it depend on the requirement, okay, situation tu. So a change from female to male is called as protogeny. Okay, change from male to female is called as protoandry. Okay, male to female protoandry, female to male protogeny. So this happens under social control, such as in cases of absences of male in a particular group, the largest female can change into a dominant male. So dalam grup ikan ni kan, so dia ada contohnya ada beberapa ikan. So let's say lah ikan jantan mati kan, ikan yang jantan mati, so the largest female will become and change to the male. Okay, it depends on the situation. Okay, so this table basically it shows you the differences between sexual and asexual reproduction. Okay, so make sure setiap kali awak buat perbezaan mesti dalam bentuk table. Okay, dan perbezaan tu mestilah selarilah tally. Kan, you are comparing apple to apple. So walaupun facts dia betul, tapi bila awak cakap fusion, involve fusion of male and female gametes, and but this one you put there's no genetic variability. Walaupun facts dia betul, tapi when you are not comparing apple to apple, then your answer will be wrong. Okay, so basically for the first differences between sexual and asexual reproduction is that for sexual it involves obviously fusion of male and female gametes, okay, fertilization to occur, and then for asexual reproduction no fusion of gametes, okay, there's no production of gamete at all for this asexual reproduction. So for sexual reproduction, parent and offspring are not identical, okay, they are not this is because they do not have the same phenotype due to they are not genetically the same. Okay, so ada banyak faktor lah. Satu disebabkan oleh apa? Disebabkan oleh random fertilization. Lagi satu, you have many sperm kan? You have many sperm. Only at one point certain sperm can fertilize the egg. Okay, so this sperm will carry different genetic material. Okay, different combination of genetic material. So another factor that contributes to the parent and offspring that are not identical, that do not have the same phenotype, is due to for example the process of meiosis kan. So masa meiosis akan berlaku contohnya crossing over, okay, so that causes the gamete to carry different genetic material. Okay, so for the asexual reproduction, parent and offspring are identical. Okay, so sebab apa? Daripada one single parent tu akan divide to produce the offspring with the same genetic material. So for the next difference is the genetic material lah. So for sexual, they have high genetic variability. Okay, so genetic diversity increase the chances of survival in unstable environment. So dengan adanya genetic variation ni, dia membolehkan organism lebih senang adapt. Okay, lebih senang adapt kepada environment yang berbeza. Okay. So lagi satu, kalau asexual reproduction, there's no genetic variability. So therefore genetic uniformity leads to susceptibility to disease. So maksudnya disebabkan oleh macam satu koloni bakteria. Okay. Disebabkan genetic composition are the same, tapi tiba-tiba dia diserang tiba berlaku perubahan lah pada surrounding, okay, berlaku perubahan pada surrounding dia, bakteria ni tak boleh nak survive. Okay, so these are for the organism that has no genetic variability, they are susceptible to disease. Okay, to be continued.